Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you a new palette from Alter Ego. This is the Artemis palette with this beautiful emerald green packaging. And if you guys have not heard of Alter Ego, they do make a lot of dupe palettes for a lot of the Natasha Denona ones and some of the Huda Beauty palettes, and they are really great. The company's amazing as well. All the people behind the brand are really nice, very genuine, and I really do like the Alter Ego brand. I think they make some amazing palettes, and if you guys can't afford the big ones, like the Natasha Denona ones can be in the $100 range, I think these are a good option if you want the same color scheme. So this is the Artemis palette, like I said, and this is going to be a dupe for the Natasha Denona Metropolis palette, which is like $129, something around there, craziness. And here is the shades in the Artemis. So it's going to have pretty much the same color scheme as the Metropolis. I, of course, decluttered my Metropolis because I wasn't a huge fan of it. I spent so much on it and I was hardly using it. I think I only used it like 2 times and I just felt like it was a repetitive palette. So probably some of my opinions on that palette will be the same for this. But I did try this out quite a bit. I wore it yesterday. I have it on my eyes today. I did film today's tutorial and I'll go through a little bit of what I did yesterday with this palette. I did kind of a warm orangey look yesterday and this one's more olive green tones that are in here. So there is quite a bit of shades in here. This is going to retail for $22. I do have a 10% off code with Alter Ego, so you could save a little bit there. But yeah, it's a lot more affordable than the Natasha Denona price tag if you want those kind of colors. This does include 28 shades. The pans are a little bit smaller than their normal ones. So this is the Sahara from them, and these are the pan sizes in the Sahara compared to the Artemis. So they are a bit smaller so that they could fit more in, I will say that. But that's kind of what Natasha Denona did with the Metropolis palette as well. What's interesting with the Alter Ego version, they did rearrange the shades. You're getting the same colors in here, but they are arranged differently, and I feel like this arrangement is much more appealing to the eye. I will insert the Natasha on this side, a picture, so you guys can see. But yeah, it's not exactly the same arrangement. They definitely rearranged them around, but they kept like the same amount of shades. Something that I really think Alter Ego should have done if they wanted to kind of make it a little bit more appealing than the Natasha Denona palette is actually to kind of eliminate some of the duplicate shades. Like, there are so many shades that swatch almost very identical to each other, very similar. There's a lot of oranges in here, those coppery colors. A lot of the mattes in here swatch the same, the browns, the greens, and the blues are just like so similar. There's only a little bit of difference to them. I kind of wish they did less shades in this palette, maybe made it the same size as the regular ones, and so it wasn't so many of the same tones, if that makes sense. That would have made it a really good layout and color scheme for me, because it bothered me so much in the Metropolis that there was like 2 shades that maybe had like the little tiniest bit of difference in it. It just seems so unnecessary. There is a few different formulas in here that I found. There is some that almost feel like a cream to powder shade, and I didn't test out my Metropolis palette that much before I ended up getting rid of it, so I don't know if that one did have some of those cream to powders, but I know in my Natasha Denona bronze palette it does have one of those or two. And they're very weird. They're almost like you can see the indentation in it where I swatched them. It's almost like it's just like creamy, and it's like it made an indentation because it's almost like a putty, and then you put it on the eyes and it kind of blends out, not as easy as some normal mattes, but you have to kind of keep working with them. So I did struggle a little bit like with the shades in here, trying to get them to build up with those. It's a unique formula, but it's also a little bit harder to work with, but it is going to be more sheer. If you guys like a lighter wash of color at first, you'll probably like that, but they do definitely take some building up. So I do want to go ahead and insert these swatches here. They swatch beautifully, I will say. The shimmers just have so much punch and pigment to them, but you'll notice in these swatches, like some of those shades, they look almost identical. So those are the swatches, a little bit of an intro to the Artemis palette. Let's go ahead and get into the tutorial. So I am just going to be doing one tutorial style look with this here on camera today, but I did film a little Instagram story, which I'm going to insert here, wearing this with a more orange toned warm look from yesterday, and it lasted really well on me for a photo shoot. I was sweating, changing my outfit like so many times, and I was impressed with how it held up. So I'm gonna insert the clip of that, and I'll insert what colors I used for it as well. And then here's the look I did with the Artemis palette today. Super gorgeous. The shimmers in here are really pretty. So yeah, let me know if you guys want a review this week. We'll see if I can upload one on Thursday maybe. So let me just actually go over that real quick. I did use this warm kind of yellow shade Entice that was in the crease. And then I also went over that with this kind of satin color called Quiver. It's like a medium brown. I went over that in the crease. And then for the outer corner, I used Lure, which is a deeper brown, which worked really well, surprisingly, for a kind of shimmery color. It's not super shimmery, but like I said, a more satin finish. And then I did Provoke all over the lid. I put it on a brush first, and then I used my finger with it. And this one was super, super shimmery and gorgeous. I got so many compliments from you guys on my look. And then I took this shade Thrill on the lower lash line. And yeah, everything performed pretty well. So I want to do something a little bit more, I don't know, something with the greens, blues in this, since there is so many orangey warm shades in here. I'm just using the Alter Ego eye primer as well with this, which is also a really great primer and super affordable. But you can use any primer that you guys want, but this one does work very well and does keep the makeup from creasing. And since it kind of leaves a bit of a stickiness, I do set that primer with my translucent powder. So I just put this on top. Alright, so for this look, I'm actually just going to go straight into Quiver here and just place this in the crease. It's a little bit hard to build this one up, just the texture of it. It does have that satiny finish, so it's not a complete matte, but it still looks really pretty on the eyes, and it blends out really well too. I want to mix a bit of this Prowl shade also in the crease and see what that will do to the look. I'm just really curious. This is another satin. It might be darkening a bit, but I don't think it's really doing a whole lot to the look. Maybe making it a bit more brown. I'm gonna try out this Stealth, like emerald dark green color on the outer corner. I know Natasha sometimes has those cream to powder formulas. I think that's what this is, because it's really creamy in the pan and then it blends to a powder. So these can be a little bit harder to blend, but they are kind of trying to emulate that same formula that Natasha uses. So that makes it like a really good dupe, because you're basically getting the same finishes from it. But I don't know, I'm not really having much trouble blending it out. It seems to be blending pretty good. Actually, let me zoom you guys in so you guys can actually see what I'm doing up close. I think I might want to put this in the inner corner too and do a halo eye with this look, because right now this green and yellow is reminding me of either the Packers colors or like John Deere, if you guys are familiar with tractors. I don't know, you know, in Iowa it's all about farming here, so that's what it is reminding me of right now. So I'm going back in with Stealth again, and I'm gonna place that in the inner portion as well, just to kind of do a halo eye with this. Then we'll take our blending brush and just kind of go back and forth in that area to get everything all smooth. And I am gonna place a shimmer in the lid, which will hopefully, I mean, the lip's not bad, but I think the shimmer is definitely gonna make it like top notch. But actually first, I kinda wanna do that Thrill shade again that I used yesterday on the lower lash line again. It's just really nice. And then I am gonna wet my brush here, this little flat brush. And I always get questions like, what do I use to wet my brush? It doesn't matter what you use, you can pretty much use anything. I always use whatever I have next to me, so setting sprays, but it's kind of an expensive thing to use that for, so you can just dip it in water. It literally works the exact same. It does not matter what you use, you'll get the same effect. Okay, so next I'm gonna go into this shade, Chase, which is a really pretty like olivey bronze, and place this in the center.
Ooh, I really like that color. It's gorgeous.
I feel like I need a little bit more shine, so I'm gonna go in with this shade, which is Scent, and pop that right on top with my finger. I'm not gonna add too much, it's just gonna give a little bit of extra glitter. So here is the makeup look I'm doing for today with the eyes. I am gonna add these lashes. Alter Ego was kind enough to send a few pairs over, so I haven't tried these yet. This one's in Plush that I'm gonna try right now. So I'm gonna trim these down just a bit. These look like a little bit more of a natural lash, so we'll have to see what they look like. And by the way, all the products I have on my face, I will link down below in the makeup I'm wearing section as well. I'll probably post an Instagram look for this tomorrow too, so that I'll have all that info. But I feel like I found a really good lip combo with this eye. I used the Pat McGrath contour lip liner with the Wayne Goss lip gloss. This one is in Tulip on top, and I just feel like it matches together perfectly. And then I did a more bronzy cheek. That actually went on really easy. I'm impressed. The lash band isn't too thick and it's not too thin. I don't like a huge thick lash band, and these just give a little bit more volume to the eyes. It's nothing too crazy long. I have smaller eyes, so sometimes very long lashes can just look ridiculous on me. I think these are a really nice length for my eye, so that's kind of how they look. Okay, so here is the finished look with everything done. I'm really liking these lashes a lot. I'll have to link those down below as well because they're really great. With my final thoughts on this palette, I do think it is a good dupe for the Natasha. I've talked about and compared the formulas before. I'll link one of my previous videos below comparing two of the palettes together. The Natasha formula is definitely a bit better in my opinion, but you can get the same look. But the Natasha is just a lot easier to work with. I feel like the shades are more pigmented, they take less blending out, while this one does take a little bit more work and effort. But like I said, you do get the same look. It just depends if you want to cut time or what. There is definitely a reason that Natasha's eyeshadows are priced so high, because they are really good quality. But for the price tag here at $22, the Alter Ego shades are really great as well. They make amazing dupes. If you guys just, it's so hard to justify $130 practically for an eyeshadow palette. That's all so much. There's so many other things that you can buy with that amount of money. And if you like the color scheme, like sometimes I just want the color scheme, I don't really care what brand it is, then you should definitely go for this. I know there's so many of you that have that Metropolis palette on your wish list. I think you should try this out and see what you think of it. But the same critiques as for the Metropolis, like I mentioned earlier, too many duplicate shades. I think they should have changed it up a bit. Some of those shades were harder to work with. I did struggle with this Stealth shade a lot. I had to keep building it up so many times to get some of this color payoff with it. So I did struggle a bit, but I do feel like the eye look came out pretty good. And I loved like this first row. Incredible. No complaints there. I used pretty much those colors for my last look. So with those mattes, I just struggle with them. They're such an odd formula I'm not really used to, but I feel like if you go in with a really fluffy brush and just build it up, you can get the color, and it's just gonna take a little bit more time, some working with. So I'm curious to see if you guys know if the Metropolis has that too with their mattes, if they're more of that almost cream to powder finish to them. I feel like they can be hard to work with. I don't know, I know they're trying to be exactly like the Metropolis, but I really wish that they could kind of, you know, make it their own and make it even better. Maybe for the future palettes, they can take critiques that maybe people didn't like about the Natasha Denona palettes and make their palettes like the ideal version. So I think that would be cool, but overall, I am pleased with the looks I did today. I thought it performed nicely, and I do think it is worth it, especially if you guys have been wanting the Metropolis. That's pretty much all I have for you guys today. I'll have this palette linked down below if you guys want to pick it up or check out any of the other palettes that they have. I'm really hoping, well, I'm sure the next one they're gonna do is a dupe for the Love palette, which I actually don't have that one either. So I think I'm gonna hold out for the Alter Ego dupe and have that whole color scheme because I think it's gorgeous. So I really hope they do the Love palette next from Natasha, and maybe even the Huda Mercury retrograde would be cool. Or if they made the pastel palettes, that would be cool because I know a lot lot of people don't like those from Huda, and if Alter Ego could make them just like even better, then that would be really amazing. But yes, that is all I have for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I will go ahead and let you guys go and see you in my next video. Bye guys.